What does it mean to be transgender?
Being trans is just being another person, you know? It's not something someone has to label themselves as.
When children are born, gender and sex type are determined based on anatomy. People who identify as transgender would say they were assigned a sex that isn't true to who they really are. There's a surprisingly high number of transgender kids and teens who are rejected by their parents. Some even become homeless.
Their families don't accept them, and they're just, you know, kicked out by their families for just being who they are. You don't know where you're going. You don't know, you know, am I going to make it to the age of 21? Like, am I going to make it to these milestones that people have? Because I'm so sad and I just don't feel like me.
And to come and to have to tell your parents or your significant caretaker, I'm in a body that's not mine, this is not who I am, is one in and of itself like jumping the Grand Canyon, because you don't know that reaction.
That's why there are places young people can live with acceptance and feel safe at all times.
Support of others is so big because, you know, who we are as people and our connections with other people is really strong in our lives, especially with family and friends.
One home, one family, dedicated to trans teens in need of help.
That message that Safe Harbor wants to say is, it's safety above all else. Safety is the key.
I am Marcus Pizer, and when I first started my transition, I was 16 years old. You know, I had always had a feeling that I was different. Like, when I was little, I thought I was a boy, but I just felt so wrong and was sad and not comfortable with myself.
Marcus was isolating, angry, didn't want us around, wouldn't be up on the computer all hours of the night. It became an issue of we needed the electronics and just really not wanting to talk to us and very angry.
And it was that time that I was like, okay, like, who am I? People are trying to figure out what they like and what sports they play, and I was playing sports with girls, and I'm like, this is not who I should be running with, this is not who I should be passing a ball with. I really started to figure out, okay, this is not who I am.
And we were really concerned that we were gonna lose Marcus. And so we went through about a year and a half of working in extreme therapeutic intensity, Marcus not being at home, Marcus being in a group house.
I hadn't, like, really looked at what it was to be transgender because I had no idea that it was even a thing. I didn't know people could really change their genders. I was like, oh God, that fits me. Like, that's exactly who I am. So I'd been sitting with that, trying to figure out how am I gonna come out with this. And finally, I told my therapist, and I was like, you need to turn around. I made him turn around so I could tell him. I've always wanted to be a boy, I think I'm trans. It was like a weight off my shoulders. It was the most freeing thing I think I had done. And when I finally told my parents as well, that was a shock. They didn't really know at first.
So Molly Ann Pizer was gender given name at birth for a female baby. And as Marcus transitioned and became male, we went to Marcus Finley Pizer. We love Marcus, but you have to realize for a parent, that also means it's a death of an individual in a way. And coming through the realization of Molly, who really wasn't with us, and probably wasn't with us for a long time, was gonna be put away forever. But then through extensive, it took me really 6 weeks of kind of going through almost like a mourning period to realize it's really the packaging, the soul inside is the same.
Finally started my transition, it was 2015, it was January, I first started by cutting my hair. I didn't start big because I wanted to take it slow. I wanted to go slow and do it with my parents.
And I'm realizing, really, there is no Molly, which I know that, but now I'm like, Molly's really gone. You know, I mean, there was some features in there where I could kind of look at Marcus and say, I see a little bit of Molly, but Molly's gonna be male with facial hair. And that's the transition. So we're still going through it.
After a month or two, I went out by Marcus. I was starting to tell people I would like to be referred to as Marcus and have people put my pronouns as he, him. I remember in the lunch line, my picture was still my freshman year picture. So every time I'd put in their number, they're like, are you Molly? And I was like, it's Marcus. And that can be a little hard, but it is rewarding in a way. It's empowering to hear people use the right terms. My senior year, I first started testosterone on the 2nd of October. So I've been on testosterone for a year and almost 5 months. So that is a big difference with where I am now. Completely changes everything, my voice, my hair, my body. I just wouldn't change a thing. I've come so far. And to look over, you know, when I first came out and to when I started testosterone to when I got surgery, and just looking at all of those milestones, I just feel accomplished. I feel empowered. I realize the privilege that I've had to grow up in a nice town with such supportive people in Vermont. So I have just wanted to help other kids that have not been as fortunate as I have. So I came home one day from school and I was like, Mom, what can we do to help other, you know, trans youth and adults in the community? What can we do to help people? Because I have been so lucky, I want to help others that haven't. I want to be a supportive person in the trans community, in the LGBT community.
I wanted to honor that with Marcus because I thought that was a true statement. And that's kind of where Safe Harbor came about.
After some consideration of what we wanted to do, we decided we would be Safe Harbor for trans teens. We decided first we'd start with foster care, so we were going to focus on trans youth for now. And we had to get certified as the, you know, as a trans household that we can help trans youth, and we were the first registered in the state.
It gives them a resource to call. We do a lot of advocacy, and we talk on advocacy, taking individuals at any given point. Once a month, I have a meeting in a room with 15 individuals that I have to say, this person's not a possession. We are not a facility, we're a home. They need these supports. I work with their therapists. I work in all their medical, what they need medically to help them.
A lot of people feel like they need some separation from their family because it's just such a heated thing. It's such a heated topic that when you come out, you know, you need a little space to separate, to regulate, and to let your parents kind of sit with something.
I don't think we're on the street enough to actually get to the people who I feel are in the most dire need. We get them if they get picked up, meaning that they wind up in custody or that someone gets our number. We get a lot of phone calls from youth or questions from grandparents or parents because they don't feel comfortable walking into the community of the LGBTQ. And that's why Safe Harbor is important, is that you can be out in the world but still be isolated even among a crowd.
It's nice to come home to like a full house instead of an empty one. You know, since my siblings are out of the house, I'm used to just having it be my mom, my dad, and me, and the puppies and cats. But with these kids, like, one, we give them a safe home to live in, and like also just support them in ways that I wouldn't imagine we could have.
And you have to be ready that at any given time, anything can go on. Meaning that you have a lot of personalities together. So it's like having a family reunion all the time at your house. When I'm asked who is staying or who is with Safe Harbor, I'm so cautious and leery to answer the question because of a stigma. Because I'm not the expert or is anybody else to exactly define who that is. They're human beings at the time who need to be loved, who need to feel safe, and they need to be who they are as people. What do you give up personally? I can't run around my house in my underwear. What you gain is a lot of love and support. It's not just that we're supportive as a family, but it comes both ways. You know, once we're all together as a community and we call ourselves a community, we call ourselves a family, there is a sense of you're never alone.
Youth can stay at Safe Harbor as long as it takes for them to feel safe and ready to leave. It's not limited. Colleen Sanford is a registered nurse case manager from Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Vermont, who has been working closely with the Pizer family and other transgender youth throughout Vermont.
So when we found out from Blue Cross Blue Shield that there was somebody who dealt specifically with the transgender surgeries, that was amazing and a gift. But to get Colleen, I mean, she truly is a remarkable human being. There's a compassion level there that is beyond what her job is.
My name is Colleen Sanford, and I'm a registered nurse and a certified case manager for our transgender members. Case managing transgender members is no different than case managing any of our members. I think the reason to have one person is because of the sensitivity. We do a whole person assessment because we case manage the whole person. We don't separate out the mental health and medical. We treat them all the same.
We had called Blue Cross and Blue Shield, and my dad, he tells the story the same every time. You know, he was calling and he's like, I have a feeling you have never heard of this before, that this is going to be completely new to you.
He was dreading calling the insurance company to change the name of his son, and when he heard such a positive response and knew that he had a person he could talk to, one person, to answer all his questions, they were so very appreciative of that.
You instantly have a liking, you know, and she'll give you a big hug when you see her. And, you know, that's kind of what you need when you're going through. It's sort of the behind the scenes that you think that can never happen. And I'm still in shock because she set the bar so high.
I think it's becoming better because the trans community is close-knit. They stick together. They talk to each other. Transgender has always been around. This is not a new thing. I think it's just neat being talked about more. And I think the more we talk about it and the more education, I think the more acceptance. Because there is so much violence and high suicide rates and murder rates of transgender people because people just don't understand.
You don't take on that role and do it as eloquently and as caring if you're not a compassionate person. And that she is.
Safe harbor for trans teens is important because I think parents just, they have a difficult time. And it's a grieving process for parents. They go through the denial. They go through the anger. They go through the fear. And so having a safe place like Safe Harbor for trans teens for them to go to and be supportive while the parents are working through those issues is helpful.
You want to empower these youth. You want them to make them feel good and happy and safe.
There is something about feeling safe and knowing that there's nothing wrong with you and you can go somewhere and be who you are, whatever that may be.
I have a really amazing family and thankful for them to have them in my life and be there for me in ways that I couldn't imagine. And at first, I definitely thought they wouldn't be.
I have gained such respect for Marcus that this is an individual who really has a lot to offer the world. And it's really within Marcus.